Do you want to do the announcements now or the group sign now?
Okay, I can.
We'll do the group sign. Yeah. Okay. It's the time of the year when we start getting close to Easter, but I don't know about you. I think about Christ coming back every day in my life. What a wonderful gift we have, just knowing that He is coming back. Pray for us. We haven't practiced this. We've sung it before. We're actually going to sing along with the CD. Listen to the verses of the song. I love the words. I love especially the chorus where we say the King is coming. Okay, y'all stand up.
Okay. The announcements. Let's see. First of all, while I'm thinking about it, next Sunday will be change of time. Am I right?
Amen.
Okay. So it'll be a bring forward. 1 o'clock, it'll be 2. Don't be late. I had to get that out of the way, or I'd have forgot it. Okay, daylight saving time. Of course, as we continue on here tonight, the services will begin at 5 o'clock, as usual, and we'll have a little fellowship downstairs. If you can make it early, please do. And so, of course, Wednesday night at 6:30. So I want to invite you to that. This time, let's see who we got here that takes up the offering. Larry and who's the other one?
Jim.
Okay. If y'all would, come on up and take up the offering.
Jim's busy, so maybe Brother Carlos.
Yeah, he's going to, I think, Brother Carlos.
While they're coming, the old printing machine has officially died. So we're ready to use the new one. Those of you that use it, and a lot of people do, if you'll hang around for just a minute, come back to the office, I'll just go over the simple directions for operating, and anybody can do it. But I thought if we went over it one time, it might help.
Carlos?
Yeah.
Yeah. Brother Carl, if you will, bless the offering.
Dear Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord. We're so grateful that we have the privilege of coming today and worshiping you. It is so wonderful that we live in a country where we have this freedom yet. We're so grateful for all your many blessings. We ask that you be with all those who are sick and in need. Bless them. If it be thy will, Lord, we pray that these tithes and offerings will be generous and help you, Lord, to spread your word and gather in those who are very needy, Lord. We ask this in your precious name, Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
This is Mike.
Hey.
This is a song that I haven't heard in a while. As I was trying to learn it, Faith come in where I was trying to learn it and said, that was a song that Brother Kenny used to sing. So that just made the song that much more special to learn. I hope y'all like it. I'm kind of homesick for a country to which I've never been before. No sad goodbyes will there be spoken, for For time won't matter anymore. Beulah Land, I'm longing for you. And someday on thee I'll stand. There my home shall be eternal. Beulah Land, sweet Beulah Land. I'm looking now across the river to which I've never seen before. There's just a few more days to labor, then I will take my heavenly flight. Beulah Land, I'm longing for you. And someday on thee I'll stand. There my home shall be eternal. Beulah Land, sweet Beulah Land. There my home shall be eternal. Beulah Land, sweet Beulah.
Thank you for that good song, song of inspiration. Don't forget to pray for Brother Tommy especially, and for Sister Jeanette and all the others that we've mentioned on prayer this morning. So hopefully Brother Tommy will get to be back maybe with us by Wednesday night. Just pray. This time, we'll ask Brother Billy Street, if he will, come up and give us the message this morning, and the Lord will have him.
Thank you, brother. Hey, good morning, everybody. Good to see everyone out this morning. I wish I was up here under different circumstances, but you know, maybe Papa was in the best spot right now to get him well. I have, at the end of the service, if anybody would like the number to get a hold of him at his, in his room, I've got it. I think Brother Bill has it. Brother Snooks has it, so any one of us, if you'd like to get a hold of him, talk to him. We've got the number to his room. This morning, I'd like to sort of talk to y'all about scriptures in Christ and what we can all profit from it from individual standpoints here. The text this morning I'm going to be reading from is John Chapter 5, verse 39. And this is Jesus speaking. John chapter 5, verse 39. He says, "Search the scripture, for in them, ye think ye have eternal life. And they are they which testify of me. Now, we read that. This is Jesus speaking. He's saying, search the scripture. We're trying to find Christ and have eternal life. Also says, he adds, they testify of him as the only Savior for perishing sinners. And Jesus is a mediator between our Father in heaven and us getting in. We take, and if we do our daily devotions, we pray. I think we talked about it this morning in Sunday school. If we put our hands in Jesus, He will make sure that He will be there beside us whenever we go through them heavenly gates. An individual can profit from scriptures when they reveal himself or her the needs of Christ. Over in Matthew chapter 9, verse 12, let me peel this away here. Now this is Jesus speaking again. He says, but when Jesus heard that, and he said unto them, that they be whole need not a physician, but they are sick. And here we go. We read down in the 13. But go ye and learn what meaneth, I have mercy and not sacrifice. For I am not come to call for the righteous, but the sinners to repent. Christ didn't come down here. He wasn't born to come down here and find all the people that do good things and aren't saved. He come down here for people like me that sin every day of my life. And He knows it. I know it. But I keep a special spot in my heart for Christ. And He walks beside me. I pray to Him. I talk to Him. He knows my heart. He knows each and every one of our hearts. And if we just take and look for that, He will show it to us in the Bible. If we do our daily devotions, and if we read the Bible, He will show us the path that we need to be on. We can also profit from the Scripture when they make Christ reveal to ourselves. When an individual is more real, when Christ is more real to us, then we're going to learn more from it. In John 14:21, it says, he that has the commandments and keepeth them, he it is that loveth me, and he that loveth me shall be loved of my Father. And I will love him and will manifest myself to him. So if we live by the commandments, if we keep right, then He's going to love us. The Father's going to love us. He's going to make sure that we have a heavenly home. He's going to make sure that you have what you need day-to-day life. Now there's going to be things that are wants, and there's things that you need. Well, Christ is going to make sure you have the things that you need whenever you get up in the morning, you go to work. He makes sure that you're safe during the day. He makes sure that you come home at the end of the day, sees our families. He's there with us. You might not know it, but He is. But it tells us right there, and I will love Him and manifest myself to Him. The more we the more that Christ is more real to us, the more He's going to continue to manifest Himself to us. The more that we are going to be able to see Him on a daily basis. We can also profit from the Scriptures when Christ is more engrossed with perfections. The more real Christ becomes to us, the more we are attracted to His perfections, and great need is to be occupied with Christ. We as Christians are just here on this earth until we get to heaven. That is why we are here this morning, is to learn the Word and to be close to Christ. We are here to make sure that we have a daily walk with Christ. And I go on and say, you know, whenever we have that, it's going to be a great thing. If there's someone here that's not saved this morning, I urge you to look deep into your heart and look, because Christ is here for you. He tells us right over here. He says that right over there in Matthew chapter 9:13. I will have mercy and not sacrifice, for I don't call on the righteous, but I call on the sinners to repent. So if you bow your head and you ask Christ to forgive you of the sins that you have done, and you stay true to that, and your heart is washed, those sins are behind you, you don't have to worry about them one more day. They are struck from your record, and you're on a straight path. And that is a great thing. I'm glad to say that I am saved, and that whenever I've been saved twice. I was saved years ago, and then just a few months ago, I asked to be re-saved and re-baptized. It just felt like it was something I had to do at that particular point in my life. The devil was really, really hard on me, and was really, really trying to get back in my life, and I didn't like it. And I wanted to re-pledge and dedicate myself to the Lord, and I'm glad I did, because the devil has been knocking at my back door, and he's been trying to get in, and I don't have to worry about it. That gate is locked, it's chained, it's got a padlock on it so great the fire of hell cannot burn that thing into, because Christ has put a padlock there to make sure the devil can't play in my life anymore. Christ is something that is very real, and he's here for each and every one of us. As each individual reads the Scripture, we can also profit as Christ becomes more precious to us. He tells us in Psalms chapter 73, verse 23, the more we are engaged with Christ's perfections, the more love and adore Him. But where real and fellowship is cultivated, Christians will be able to say, "Whom have I have but Thee? And there is none upon earth that I desire but Thee." That is Psalms chapter 73:25. "Whom I have in Thee, in heaven but Thee. And there is no one upon earth that I desire besides Thee." Christ walks with us. He's here with us, but He's not here in form. He is heaven. He is there. And as we go through our lives, that's something I hope that it, each and every one of us is working towards, is to be in heaven. Is it, that we're going to be able to see each and every one of my brothers and sisters walking them streets of gold. I hope that whenever the rapture comes, that He just takes us all and there's none of us that are left behind. So whenever we fellowship, whenever we get together Sunday evenings at 4, whenever we're fellowshipping, Christ is there. Christ is with that fellowship. Where there's more than two people gathered, He's there. He's with us riding down the car or riding down the highway. He's here at this church. He's everywhere. We can profit from the Scripture as increasing confidence in Christ. Now this morning, Brother Bill was talking about Herodias, if I said that right. Whenever there is little faith over in Matthew chapter 14, this sort of talks about Herodias and little faith. It says in chapter 14, chapter 3, it says, "For Herod had laid hold of John and bound him and put him in prison for Herod's sake, his brother's Philip's wife." Now, I mean, at that time, Brother Bill had spoke about that this morning. He was put in a dungeon until his head was cut off. I mean, and I can imagine what little faith he had at that point in time. And then as we increase our confidence, we can get greater in faith. We can move on. And over in Matthew chapter 8, verse 10, Jesus says, When Jesus heard it, He marveled and said to them that followed, "Verily I say unto you, I have not found so great faith, no, not in Israel." As we take and as we are built up, as we read and our faith gets greater, Christ sees this, and he will just make sure that we have what we need. The faith, we have to have faith in Christ. If we don't have faith in Christ, we have nothing. We might as well not even be here this morning. Our faith is what ties us to Jesus, and Jesus is our path to heaven. The more that we walk with Him, the stronger bonds we have with Him, the devil can't get to us, and the easier it is going to be getting to heaven. Now, there's going to be some people, there's going to be atheists out there that don't believe in Christ. There's going to be people out there that wait till the last minute, and it's going to be too late. They're going to reach for that door handle, and that door's going to be closed, and there will be no more getting into heaven. And it's up to each and every one of us to reach out to those people and help them. Help them see. Help them see that there's a greater place other than this earth. Now, I'm going to tell you, it's my belief that we're living in hell right now. This is just a precursor before we get to heaven. This is just it. And I believe whenever He comes, He will take all of us with Him. I hope and I pray that. I hope to see each and every one of y'all walking the streets of gold. I hope that we'll have great fellowship up there in heaven. The full assurance of faith. over in Hebrews chapter 10, we can read a little bit of that. The full assurance of faith, it says in Hebrews chapter 10, verse 22, it says, "Let us draw near with a true heart and full assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience and our bodies washed with pure water." Draw near with a true heart and full assurance. Christ will be there. Full assurance of faith. Full assurance. You're not going to find that faith in the newspaper, on the cell phone. You're going to find that in Christ. You're going to find that you're going to be able to get to where you need with the love of Christ. Then lastly, trusting the Lord with all your heart. Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 says, "Trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thy own understanding." Put your trust in God. Don't go by what you think you know. Go by what Christ lets you know. Christ will let us know anything that we ask Him. He will make sure that we're pointing in the right direction. If we take and steer away from asking Christ, we're going to go down the wrong path. And that's what the devil wants. He don't want us to lean on Christ. He wants you to lean on your own understanding. He wants you to make the mistake. That way, whenever you get to heaven, to them pearly gates, and they pull up that scroll and they start reading off what's been going on. Well, let's see here, Mr. Joe Smith. See here, yep, you were saved, but you just fell away from Christ. You didn't trust in Christ anymore. You started hanging out with the wrong crowd. You started doing drugs. You started drinking. You started keeping different hours. He's probably not going to make it into heaven because he wasn't faithful through his walk. The devil got a hold of him and brought Mr. Joe Smith down. He's not going to take you. Whenever you take and ask for forgiveness, whenever you ask that, and all your sins are gone, everything, the keys, the door's locked, the padlock's there, you've got one of the greatest gifts that you can ever have is eternal life. But if we don't take and study and go through our daily devotions, we can take and be manipulated by the old devil. He can take and steer you in the wrong direction. Now I'm going to take and ask y'all a question. How many of y'all took and seen the multicolored dress on television? A couple of times, right? Okay. I've seen two pictures. I've seen one that was white and gold. I've seen one that was blue and black. There, who knows what color that dress is? But I heard a doctor trying to describe why that was happening. He says it's the lighting from your optical nerve playing tricks on you. Much like the devil can play tricks on you, he can take and manipulate what you see and make you feel like that you're doing the right thing. And all it takes is just one slip up Get on a patch of ice. We all know how that is this past week, don't we? You get on a patch of ice and slip and you're gone. Hey, he can just keep you going down the wrong path and you don't even know it. But I want y'all to think about that. I want y'all to think. Look deep down. If there's someone that's here this morning that don't know Christ in the right way, hey, we urge you to come. We've got some great people here to pray. I'll kneel down and pray with you. If y'all don't know Christ this morning, we'd love to come up, have you come up, pray with you, and invite you. So, if we can take and get a pianist up here, maybe not a song, maybe just some light music. And if there's someone that feels that they need to come up here and pray, then come up here. We'll pray with you. It don't take but just a minute. And you know, if there is anybody here, we have a. If there's a lady here this morning, a young lady, older lady, it doesn't matter. We have some great women that can kneel down and pray with you. And as Miss is playing this soft music, I want you just, everybody just bow your head. Everybody just bow your head. And let's just take a moment and look deep down in our hearts. Are you really saved? Is your name written in the book of life? Whenever you get to them pearly gates of heaven, are you going to be able to walk right through with no problems? Or are you going to be stopped because the devil played a little bit too much in your life? We don't want this to happen to you. We want you to walk through them through them pearly gates, onto them streets of gold, and be able to fellowship with us for eternal life. If there's anyone here this morning that needs prayer, we ask you to come. We thank you for coming out this morning. I know I ain't Papa, but I tried. maybe he'll get to feeling a little bit better. He'll be back Wednesday, hopefully. If not, we'll figure out what to do Wednesday too. You have a great group of people here. Brother Bill Snooks, Linda, Judy, Miss Hambell. Singers were great this morning. So if we could y'all rise for prayer, we just remember Brother Tommy, Sister Jeanette, all of our people on our prayer list. Brother Snooks, would you dismiss us, please?
Our Heavenly Father, we're grateful for this day, and Lord, we thank you for Brother Ben and the stand he took for you. We pray, Lord, you guide us on his life. Lord, we pray especially for Brother Tommy this morning to be ever near him. We know his heart's here, so Lord, we just pray for him to be ever near and be with his needs, Lord, this morning. Whatever it was on the prayer list, Lord, we know that you remember each one. Lord, we pray your blessings on each one. Be with us as you leave this place. And be with us as you come back tonight. Lord, take care of us. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
I'm kind. kind of homesick for a country to which I've never been before. No sad goodbyes will they or time won't matter anymore. You are when I'm longing for you, and someday I'll stand there, my home shall be eternal. You the land, sweet you the land. I'm moved. Across the river, where my faith will live inside. Oh, there's just a few more days to labor. I will take my heavenly flight. You the land I'm longing for, and someday on thee I'll stand.